Yo guys, as you might have seen, I found a method to do the solo out of bounds escape on point of contact. In a speedrun, I used the solo out of bounds escape to get a speedrun world record. Using the out of bounds escape saves about 15 seconds compared to the previous method. This might not sound like a lot, but it's a lot of time in a speedrun. Setting up the out of bounds escape in a speedrun, however, is very difficult. You have 5 minutes during the last hive in which you have to do the whole setup. You have to go there, set it up, go out of bounds, climb the mountain, place a turret, get back before the hive finishes. It took me a lot of attempts to do this, but I pulled it off. You can watch the whole speedrun if you want, but you can also skip to the interesting part and go to 30 minutes and 35 seconds, where I will continue with my commentary. See you there.
Drill's under attack! We got hot. drill! Focus fire! The drill's taking too much heat! The drill's taking too much heat! The drill's taking too much heat! We're gonna lose the drill! Focus fire! On the drill! The drill is halfway there! The drill's taking too much heat! We're gonna lose the drill! Focus fire! The drill's taking too much heat! The drill's taking too much heat! The drill's under attack!
This'll work.
Drill's under attack! Thank you.
Focus fire! Scorpions, look out! The drill's under attack! We've got hostiles attacking the drill! The drill's taking too much heat! The drill's
drill is halfway there.
Keep moving.
I don't know about you. I sure could use an upgrade.
Spectre 1, looks like the next hive needs additional firepower to bring down. Black Flag is circling back for support. Keep the airspace clear.
This'll work. This'll work.
There!
Guardians, look out! Electric fence is live! Electric fence is live! Look out! We've got hostiles on the drill! Watch out! Meteors! Attacking the drill! Fire.
this I can take.
Scorpion!
Yo guys, welcome back. As you can see, I just set up the final hive. I killed a few aliens and I placed down an IMS. I upgraded the IMS to +4, so that's two extra shots. Those two extra shots might save me if things get bad. I also turned on the electric trap, which might get a kill. I don't know. The IMS is there to protect the drill while I'm gone. I'm gonna be gone for a while, so I really needed to protect the drill. Just got one kill there. I think it already shot two shots, but I'm not really sure. But as soon as I get into the second area here, everything will start spawning here and not go for the drill. So the drill is relatively safe until later, which is nice. Now I have to do the setup. I already did part of the setup during the turret hive and turret area. Normally it takes two portable turrets to get out of bounds. But I already set up one portable turret and got out of bounds partially. And set up the second portable turret, so when I arrive now, I can immediately get out of bounds, which saves me a lot of time doing the setup. I didn't do this the game before, or like many other games, and it really messed me up. This setup takes a lot of time, but doing this strategy works quite well. Now I have to climb the mountain. Scary jump I already did, so I pretty much can't get stuck anymore. I just need to climb the mountain fast enough so I can do the whole setup. Luckily, for some reason, no scorpions follow me to the second area. They stayed in the third area in this game. I don't know what triggers this, but sometimes the scorpions will stay in the third area, which is extremely helpful. The scorpions can really mess you up in the out of bounds because there's not much room to dodge the poison gas and it can really halt your progression. But in this game, they stayed away, so that was really nice. A trophy system really helps if they do follow you. And I have had the trophy system save my ass in another run, but unfortunately that run was too slow. I do this big jump, I struggled with it for a bit, but I managed to do it. Now I just have to get on top of this ledge, and I do it. And from this point, the parkour isn't that hard. I jump to this triangle, follow this line, and I've pretty much done it. Now I'm in the third area again, so things will start to spawn again in the third area, and go for the drill. So that's why that IMS is super important. I set up a portable turret. I empty it so I can do portable turret clipping. IMS just got another kill. This triggers the rhino to spawn, which is actually quite nice, because when the rhino spawns, the hunter spawns stop for a second. So that rhino is actually helpful right here. I go back into inbounds by using the line, which I will also walk in the escape. I do it slowly now, so I make sure I don't die. Not that it really matters. I could just die and I will respawn about here, but I decided to play it safe since I have time enough. Drill is still like 2 minutes before it ends, so I can chill. The IMS is also only like 3 or 4 shots in, so I'm pretty sure the drill is safe. It also has 1-4 health, so it should be fine. I shoot a rhino here, I want to kill it so it doesn't mess me up later, but for some reason it just walks away. So I decide to ignore it, and I don't know what happened to that rhino, but I never saw him again. He was just gone. I check real quick to see if my portal turret is 1 bullet. Because this is not my first run. It took a lot of attempts to do this. The setup is really difficult. And I fucked it up many times. Luckily, this setup saves a lot of time. So once I did it, I knew I kinda had world record. Because the rest of this run was pretty decent. It was not perfect. I had like bad hives in second area. The berry hives could have been faster. But I arrived in time for the final hive to finish. I just have to wait it out now. Make sure there's no poison gas on the hive when it ends, so the poison gas doesn't slow me down. As you can see, I bought the SA805. I did this to shoot the scorpions while I was doing the out of bounds setup. Like normally, I have a bulldog from the second barrier hive. But I swapped it out for an assault rifle, so it has more range, which is easier to kill scorpions with. Because the scorpions is what make the out-of-bounds setup really difficult. Not that I really got to show it off this game, because there were no scorpions, for some reason they stayed in third area. I killed the last few aliens, so they don't mess up my escape setup. I throw ferals down. Activate the nuke, do a suicide strat. Throw ferals, pull out my MIS for the extended sprint duration. I don't think I need it here, so I could probably skip that part, but I did it anyway. I do the portal turret clipping. Hop on, hop back off. Hop back on. I do the line. I try to do it quite fast here by doing like a jump. I get inbounds again. The voice line triggers. That means the heli is gonna go to the landing spot. If you don't hear that voice line, the heli is not gonna come. But I hear the voice line, so that's amazing. I get to the helipad. I have to wait for him to land, like, a few seconds, but there he is. I get in, and at this point I knew I had world record. It still takes like 30 seconds for the mission complete to show up, so I was just waiting here with my finger on the timer button. Throw a nade for fun. And there we go. 36:42. World record by 4 seconds, I think. I'm not completely sure. Anyway, world record. This will probably be taken pretty soon as Fairly figures out how to do this. For some reason on PC, the barrier hives can be destroyed way faster. So I can't compete with his world record, unfortunately, but I did get it for a while. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.